be a runner in Boston. I would argue the best road race in the world. It's our road race. It's the Boston Marathon. Let's hear it again for all of you finishers yesterday. A little warmer than we wanted, but it's always an amazing day on the course. And today we have five very special guests.
We'll do ladies first. All right. For the ladies, in second place, running 2 hours, 22 minutes, and 51 seconds, Rose Chelimo. And in first place, running 2 hours, 21 minutes, and 52 seconds, Edna Kiplagat.
Inside, we have your third place runner, Suguru, Osako, who ran 2:10:28 on the course yesterday, his professional debut at this distance for third place. Let's hear it. How refreshing is it to see these guys walk down the stairs the same way we are? Your second place runner yesterday, one of the greatest American distance runners of all time, Galen, Rupp, and Kirui. And your 2017 Boston Marathon champion running 2:09:37, Geoffrey, Kirui. Question, what was the most challenging aspect of the race for you guys yesterday? Hardest part of the race for you?
For me, it was the downhills, actually. The uphills actually felt great going up there, and, ironically, it felt kind of good after running downhill for so long and to be going uphill. So after we got to the top of Heartbreak Hill, and then we started going down again, that's when I really started to feel it in my legs, and obviously having this guy run as fast as he did and throwing all those surges didn't make me feel any better. So those last 3 or 4 miles were definitely tough.
How about you? What was the most challenging part yesterday?
The most challenging part was from 30 kilometers to that 5 kilometers, it was where you can find the 2 kilometers at 30 minutes. So it was tough for me, but I was able to handle it.
Same question. What was hard about yesterday?
For me, the challenge was that it was from the 25 kilometers, there was the hills. After a few minutes, you go down, up, and down. That was where my challenge was.
So what shoes were you guys wearing yesterday? They looked different. I don't see anything like it. I want to know, because I was about 4 hours and 49 minutes for my time or something. Just want to know.
It's a new white shoe which they produced this year. So I think last year I used it in Chicago, and also this year I can feel it's light, comfortable, and it's like when you run, you kind of feel like the surface, the ground is good, so I like it.
Man, you're wearing the same shoes? Which model were you guys in?
We have 5. What color is this? It is good shoes because the cushion is good and good response. So everything is good.
Yeah, I wear the same thing. The Vaporflies, I think they're coming out in June. Is that right? And it's been so fun for me, you know, working with the guys back in Portland who developed that and just being a part of creating that show. And it's one of the greatest innovations I think that I've seen in all my time at Nike. It's truly incredible. You know, the foam is, it's just something about it that gives you that extra balance and recovery too. I think we definitely would be a little more sore without that foam. It really helps ease some of the pounding of running on the road so much. And you just feel fast in it. I think it's cool. So I'm excited, you know, when it comes out and see what everybody else thinks about it. Hope you guys get a chance to run in it. But it's a really, really special shoe.
I was excited to hear that you had the same challenge I had. Anybody else have the downhills as the hardest part of the course yesterday?
Yes. Ooh,
maybe those shoes will help us. All right, did the warm weather on Sunday affect your hydration and fueling plan in the race?
Yeah, for me it definitely did. I guess the only two other marathons I've run have been really warm weather races, you know, in LA and then in Rio at the Olympics, real hot and buggy. So we just kind of took the same strategy that we did there, and you just got to make a real conscious effort to drink a lot and do it early. I think that's the biggest thing that I've found, is you can't wait until you start to feel thirsty. You're starting to feel, you know, early effects of dehydration. You got to be real proactive and get on drinking early. So for me, I think that meant probably drinking about 9 or 10 ounces at every stop, and then, you know, grab some water too. That just you know, the cups that people were handing out. That was awesome having all those people out there. You know, toss it on, just try to keep cool, but. For me, the biggest thing I think is just recognizing that it's hot, it's going to be miserable, but everybody's got to deal with it. You know, it's not just you that's feeling bad, and you're not the only one that the heat's affecting. And so you got to always kind of keep that in the back of your head, especially when you're competing, is that it's something that everybody's got to deal with. So you just got to make the best of it.
Ladies, how was it dealing with the heat yesterday?
The heat yesterday was not as bad as when I ran in Moscow 2013. I can say I was able to run it because when you are preparing for marathon, you have to make sure that you have to keep enough fluids every time, especially when I'm doing like long runs. I have to adjust like 85 kilometers, I think I feel. So like yesterday, it was not something new for me because I've been doing it while I have been training. And so it was okay for me yesterday. So when I was at home, I was training. Home at home, it was warm like yesterday, so it was not a big thing for me. So I think it was okay, but I have to also treat a lot of fluids in every 5 so that it could help me all the way to finish that. So I was a little bit affected, but I thank God I finished it without any problem.
Yeah.
Okay, for me, it didn't affect so much because during the preparation, they had to take a lot of water so that it reduces dehydration during the race. And I had to take a lot of water after each 5 kilometers. I had to take at least I had to take a lot until it was about to reach another water station. I had to check.
I think I drink water at every water station. I'm sorry. So every time, I was like, okay. So, everyone asked about pre-race meal. I had a bagel and peanut butter, almond butter, trying to be healthy. And so what did you guys eat before your race? What did you eat Monday morning before you got out there to endure the Boston Marathon?
I did 2 slices of bread and tea with, I just put a little lemon and honey. Yeah.
For me, I just take tea, cup of tea, and an egg and a bread, slice of bread.
I did so much before the race.
You need 44 hours and 49 minutes of fuel. <You're right.
laughs> That's where you went.
Yeah, that's
cool.
Next step, eat half. Yep. Now that we're done, what's the next 24 hours of refueling look like after the race?
I'm in hydrate.
What are the guys eating before the race?
What did you eat before the race?
On Monday, I had fried cake and bread and strong tea.
Strong tea.
That's not good that because I was having a lot of tension, so I think it was about much. Yeah.
Maybe that was my problem. I didn't have egg and bread in the morning. I have pancakes, so I actually. I don't like running on an empty stomach, so I had some pancakes and some potatoes, just real carb heavy. Probably didn't eat a ton. You know, I get real nervous before these things, but if I had my choice, I used to try to have pancakes or waffles before I compete. That's my go-to for sure.
I set up, I don't know what should I say in English, but it's made from honey and just egg. So it's good for this and good carbohydrates.
Yeah. Are those 3 tea drinkers? How many of you are going to switch to tea before? Right? So how about the next 24 hours of fueling after the race? You know, what do you guys refuel with? This morning, after the race.
What did you eat after the race?
after the race, I kept up to my normal diet. I normally take cereal, egg, and bread and fruits.
For me, I just go and take my normal food that I used to take.
That's all me. I'm going back now, home, and get what I was taking before. Barely, who knows, barely here. Yeah. I used to use that most of the time, milk, and many milk. Yeah, many things, but mostly in Kenya and Kalenjin. Used to take most of the milk and ugali and only greens. Yeah, just that only. I don't know. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Thank you.
We went to the steakhouse last night at 2 o'clock. We were celebrating, so I might not have been the most healthy post-race snack, but you gotta have fun too. So we were in celebration mode last night, I'll take some time off now and kind of enjoy some of the things that I definitely wasn't able to have, you know, in the months leading up to this. So it's kind of our time to let loose a little bit. Not too much, we still got track season and all that coming up. We definitely want to enjoy ourselves over the week and kind of have some of those things that we weren't able to have for a while. We're in heavy training.
All right, we don't want to ruin Galen's party, but we do want to know what you're up to next in terms of racing. Is it Tokyo 2020 is your next big focus? Will we get to see you back here in Boston for 2018? What's next on the race agenda?
I think I might do a few short races as I wait for the next few marathons.
Okay. My next race now, I go back, I go try my best again to see. Maybe I try to 10,000 meters trials in Kenya. If not possible to make it. Also, we are on the way to other marathons, which is in front of us. Because a race is also a race like one in yesterday. It's 10,000, but we are many in Kenya. Maybe it's possible. It is possible also, maybe a bit Kenya to be. To consider and say that you go to World Championships Marathon or I do it trials in 10,000 meters. There is a possibility in between those two people that one in trials and also maybe championships. We can go and get messages at home. So far, yesterday we used the good shoes. I went first to congratulate Mike for giving us the good shoes. It was wonderful for me. I used that shoes. It's very good. It's very good. I was using the normal one before, but yesterday I used that. But now even I need to take care now because I'm missing my leg. It's comfortable. Yeah. Thank you for Nike.
Kind of in the same boat. I want to go back to run 10K. Try to give it one more go on the track this summer. So 10K has always been a real special event for me, and just what I've done for so long that I want to give it one more shot to really go after the World Championships this summer. And so I'll get back to the track in the short term, and you know, possibly run a fall marathon as well. You know, I don't think that that's out of the cards either. So it might be a busy year, but I'm looking forward to it. You know, it's been hard for me, I think, to kind of make the transition at first, just because I love running the track so much. But after coming here, transition is going to be a lot easier for sure. You know, this is just an incredible race. It's just a lot of fun. I mean, I think the marathoning community is something that is just so special, and I realized that more, you know, being at a race like this. The other two I ran were the trials in the Olympics, so just kind of just around elite athletes. But coming here and just seeing the excitement, enthusiasm around the town, and meeting so many people around here, it's really been special, and I've just had a blast doing it. So after this year, I'm fully moving over to the roads, just going to focus on the marathon. And obviously, Tokyo is the big goal, you know, 4 years away, but everything we're doing is kind of leading up to that. You know, as soon as the Olympics were over last year, we took that and kind of worked backwards and looked at what's going to be the best thing to prepare me to run there. And so Boston fit in perfectly with that. And I'm just excited. I've had so much fun training and running for the marathon. The races are just, they're a blast, and I think it makes it, the special thing about it is it's so much sweeter because there are so few of them, and you can only run so many of them. You know, some people might do a lot, I guess. I don't know how they do it, but they're running 7-8 more marathons a year. But you know, for me, you really only get a couple opportunities a year to race a marathon. And there's just, as you guys all know, if you ran it, there's so much that goes into, you know, the build-up and the training. And when you get it right and finish, you run that race, you run a PR, it's just that much more gratifying because there is so much that goes into it. And so I'm just excited, and you know, I'm excited to train more and get better. I think a marathon is something that you get better with experience, the more you do it. You know, there's nothing really that replicates that true feeling that you get at the end in training, as hard as you might try. So the future is bright, and I'm just excited about it.
I don't say yet, but I wanna run from track. And run for a chance for 10K. For bigger 2020, I don't say yet, but I'm going to run marathon in Tokyo 2020.
Well, thank you, Galen. You mentioned the marathon community, and it's really such a amazing thing to have the world's best runners inspiring this community. You guys do that, and we love to have the champions here with us and inspiring everything we do. So thank you so much for what you guys did on the course yesterday. Thank you for coming here and celebrating with these runners. So I'm a homer, and we definitely want to see you back next year, all of you guys. It was an amazing race yesterday. We do have a signing here, so you guys can get autographs with our champions. Thank you so much for coming out today. Thank you, Nike Boston. And congratulations, guys.
So guys, really quickly, if you can line up behind my man here with the great Red Sox hat while we allow our athletes to come down.